This is a video about cyclohexane. I'm going to be talking about its conformations and a process called ring inversion. So there are two main conformations. One is called boat conformation, the other is called chair conformation. This is how you normally see them drawn, but I want to show them to you using the molecular model. This is a molecule called cyclohexane. We have six black carbons in a ring. Each carbon has two hydrogens. Right now, this is in boat conformation. If we number the carbons 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you can see carbons 1 and 3 are higher. The other four carbons are in a plane. Boat conformation is a little bit unstable because we have two hydrogens that can be really close to each other. That makes them unhappy. But by rotating only single bonds, we can convert this into a different conformation, chair conformation. So this is supposed to look a little bit more like a chair. This would be, this triangle would be the backrest, square is the seat, other triangles, maybe a footrest. If you look at this at one specific angle, it looks like the drawing that I put on the board. Now, there are two different versions of this chair conformation. But first, I need to give you new vocabulary words, axial and equatorial. Notice that each of these black carbons right now has one white hydrogen and one red hydrogen. Right now, in this particular chair conformation, the red hydrogens are all pointing either straight up or straight down. These red hydrogens right now are in axial positions. The white hydrogens are in equatorial positions. They are going out to the sides. Think of them as pointing out from an equator. Now, ring inversion is when I convert this chair conformation into a different chair conformation. So notice right now, red hydrogens are in axial position. But by rotating only single bonds, I can end up with a different version of chair conformation. This version, my white hydrogens are axial. My white hydrogens are pointing either straight up or straight down. Red hydrogens are equatorial, pointing out to the sides. So in chair conformation, we can have either axial or equatorial groups. Axial groups were pointing either straight up or straight down, and they were alternating between pointing up and down. And equatorial groups were pointing from side to side. And in a ring inversion, all of the axial and equatorial groups switch. The axial become equatorial become axial. Thanks for watching Chemistry in a Nutshell. If you feel that I've earned it, please like this video and subscribe to my channel.